Hi guys, I uploaded a video of my AI trying to replicate my voice a few days ago, and I think it's being spread outside of my subscriber base because I'm getting more critical comments than before. But that's good because it teaches me how to make my videos better. One of the most common complaints is that I took too long to actually show people the results of the AI-generated voice. You can see this says 927, you're welcome. And there's a lot of comments complaining, like, why the heck did it take you 9.5 minutes to get to the actual results? And, like, I don't know, I guess people are kind of split, but one person's saying it would have been better if I put the results first and then put the explanation of how it worked afterwards instead of what I did there. But I'm making this video just to say that I've already tried that. So let's take a look at two videos where I did put the results first and the explanations afterward. I'm searching them up right now. This is a very impromptu video. This one, the results are like, but I put it at the beginning, about like 20% the way in, and it only got 112,000 views. And then another example is this video, where I literally have the results playing from the very beginning in this corner. It's trying to tell if a piano or a violin is playing, but I can like use that function on all audio throughout the entire video. So like this is the epitome of showing you the results from the very beginning, and it only got 62,000. So I guess what I'm saying is like, just for some reason, YouTube is much nicer to my videos if I do it with this the approach of explaining what I did, kind of taking you along with my process, and then show you the results at the end. Like this one is like my best performing AI video so far, and I did the same thing. So that's my reasoning for doing it. It makes me sound kind of selfish because I'm saying like I'm willing to make my videos worse for them to get more views, and more views is money, so I'm just like a greedy, selfish person. But it's really not that because, you know, some of my like authentic subscribers never see my less popular videos just because YouTube doesn't think that video is worthy of being shared. So it really comes down to like if I want people to see it, I have to, you know, follow this format. I'm just repeating myself at this point. And another thing is that I myself had to slog through maybe 1 or 2 weeks of programming and another 1 or 2 weeks of waiting for it to train to see those results. So to condense those 3 weeks or so into 9 minutes seems like a good deal for you. And, you know, it kind of felt nice as I was waiting for those results to come through to think to myself, oh, I can share my story with more people. So the 3 weeks, it was worth it in the end because you are being carried along with me. And also, there was one time when I uploaded an 8-minute evolution simulator video where I started it off by saying, like, I'm getting a lot of comments telling me to make my video shorter, so I'm gonna try to get this one in under 8 minutes. And then a lot of the comments were from, I guess, more diehard viewers who were saying, what, why did you cut it so short? You should upload longer videos and not appeal to the lowest common denominator. So I guess the moral of the story is you can't appeal to everyone, which I already knew. I don't know. Now that I have a second channel, I feel a lot more free to just say whatever I want. So yeah, that's the reason why I made people wait so long. I mean, another reason why it took so long to get to the point is that when I'm writing this script, I feel like I'm not saying that much. Like, I'm only saying the bare necessities, and then I record it, and it's 18 minutes. I guess I just have a lot more on my mind than I realize. I guess that's just the way my mind works. It's like I feel like I've only covered 3 topics in my mind, but then I write it down, and it's like 10 topics. And I can't sacrifice any of them because I feel like they're all important. Another thing I want to mention is that sometimes I catch my real life friends watching my videos, and it always pains me to see them watch through like the first 2 or 3 minutes that don't show results and they're bored. And I tell them in person, like, oh, skip to 9:30, that's where you actually hear it. And I shouldn't have to say that, right? The video should speak for itself. So like, and I do want to make my videos more snappy and more appealing to the masses, for the reason that like I want to be able to show my real life friends the video without feeling the urge to tell them anything else. The video should speak for itself. But that just never happens. I guess it's just I have to decide which genre of video I want to make. Maybe genre isn't the right word, but I have to think to myself, animating those 9 minutes was like grueling work, and like it took so much motivation and willpower to get through it, that if I'm suffering and the viewer's also suffering, then who wants this crap, right? Like, it's a win-win if I animate less. All I'm saying is there's pros and cons to both sides, and I have like mulled over all of them constantly. So don't think that I haven't thought about all these other options, because I have, and I've tried them, and I've tried to adapt to how those perform. And there's no easy solution, and there's nothing that will appeal to everybody. That's it for this video.